What is the difference between WordPress themes and WordPress templates? The short answer is WordPress templates define the structure of your pages and posts, while a WordPress theme defines the entire structure of your website. Your header and footer design, color settings, typography, homepage, everything is generated by the code in your active WordPress theme. Hi fellow WordPress users, and welcome to our channel. My name is Robert, and in this video I will show you some WordPress template examples and themes that give you even more options to choose from. Let me start with the default theme of WordPress, which is now 2020. If you go to the default Hello World post, or any other post you have created already, in the document settings you will find the Post Attributes tab. As you can see in this drop-down, I can change my template from default to cover or full width. Let me add more content to this post. But wait, I think it would be better to add two more articles so we can set up different templates for each article and open them in separate tabs to easily compare how they look. First, I will change the title of this article to blog post 1, then I will add some lorem ipsum text, a couple of h2 heading subtitles, and an image. Let me set this image as featured in the document settings, and that's it. Before updating the article, I will make sure the default template is set in the post attributes for this one. Now click Update and add a new post. I like to work as fast as possible, so with the Post Duplicator plugin, I get this Duplicate Post link, which I can click on to get two more posts in no time. Now I just have to edit them, change the title to Blog Post 2. The template should be Cover for this one, and Update. Let me go back to all posts and edit the last one. Its title will be blog post 3, and the template I choose for it is full width. Click Update, and then open this post in a new tab. Go back to all posts and open the remaining posts in separate tabs. So, this one uses the default template, which shows up the content like this. The second blog post looks completely different, with this full cover section at the top, but the content below has the same width, while the third article looks weird as the full width template. It seems that this theme has no sidebar at all, which I think is not that bad, because more than 70% of people navigate online from mobile devices, which makes sidebars to be displayed below the content, and people almost never get there. Now let me go to Pages and check out the available templates. In addition to the basic template, pages created with this theme can be set as cover or full width. Now let me install another theme and see if I can get more templates and options. This is Neve, which is made by Themeisle, the owner of this channel. If I edit the first blog post, you can see that there is no post attribute tab, but I can access the post settings, which allows getting full control over my template. I can set up contained or full width template, choose to display the sidebar on the left or right, or I can even deactivate it completely. As you can see, there is a customizer setting option above, which means that I can set up a default layout for my page template in the layout settings. Moreover, I can disable the header, title, featured image, and the footer too. For more control over the width of my template, I can enable this feature and adjust the value below. The full width template without sidebar looks a bit awful because of the content aligned to the left and not centered. Let's check out the sample page and see how many options we have here. Well, it looks like we get access to the same template settings, but there is a page builder full width template too, optimized for builders like Elementor, Breezy, Beaver Builder, as well as Drive Architect and Divi. If I use Elementor, for example, I get access to even more page templates in the library. And the OrbitFox Companion plugin have also a great collection of templates you can access by activating the Template Directory module. Each WordPress theme comes with unique templates, and some of them deliver a great collection of starter sites that you can use to quickly create a full WordPress website in minutes. Astra, for example, is one of the best examples, which has an outstanding collection of starter sites. OceanWP, Calibri, Hestia, all of these themes are filled with great demo content, which you can import with just a couple of clicks. I hope this video was helpful, and now you understand what is the difference between WordPress themes and templates. Let me know what is your favorite WordPress theme in the comment section below. I would like to see some websites designed with these themes, and I will feature the best ones in a new video about WordPress website examples. Keep up the good work, and see you in the next video. Cheers!